Just underway in this women's game between the Manitoba Mayhem and the Ottawa Capitals. Capitals in the red jerseys. Team from Manitoba in the gold and black. Capitals 3-0 after three games. Mayhem 2-1. That's flipped down the floor by Brownridge. We go to the goaltender, who will have to hold on. That's Jenna James in goal. That's poked wide, comes to the boards. On it was Van Dens. Taken behind the goal by Ottawa, up along the boards. Held in by Manitoba. Doucette gets it out for Ottawa. Following up on it, Pallotta. Knocked off her stick. Doucette back. Desmier. Shot scores! That seemed to fool the goalkeeper. She looked over the left shoulder. Looked like it beat her on the right. Let's take a look. Shot actually looked over the right and it beat her to the left. So a quick opening goal for Ottawa. They lead it 1-0. Kept in, then brought out. Archambault cleared it in. On it first, Lavoie. Pallotta broke that up. Dumped in by Stewart, right to the goaltender. In the corner, holding it there, Emily Smith. Mendez moves it out. That's kept in. Now Manitoba with another chance, just as far as the blue line, no further. That passed too far for Tanya Ginden, and that will be a flooring call against Ottawa. That's been moved. Show a couple of Manitoba players. She got it free though to Langan. Luttrell, good save by Glass. Ottawa coming in to the front of the goal. Pile up there. Glass has got it and holds on. In comes Desmier, shot wide. Beautour along the boards, plays it to herself. Beautour walking in, gets it down along the goal line. They work the give and go, scores, five hole. Adrienne Beautour worked that give and go to perfection. Take it off the boards, down to the goal line, and head to the goal, and you see it goes right between the wickets. Abigail Glass, and it is 2-0. Timeout, Manitoba. Stewart. Kara Brum. Forced to the boards. Flipped out. Marinyak. To Bird. Is it taken away? By Doucette. There's a trip. Not a difficult call. Chantel Archambault will go 2 minutes for tripping. Manitoba, go on the power play. Cleared down the floor. Glass will leave it for Mendez. Matula, she's poke checked as she got to the blue line. Racing in there shorthanded. Hendricks works it along the boards. Killing time. Hendricks goes down, but quickly back up and stays with the ball. Great work by Hendricks along the boards. Finally, Manitoba get it out. They need to get it in over the blue line. They do. Bragg drops it back. Bragg's got it again. Long shot in. Came off the end boards. That one missed the net. In behind the goal. Manitoba maintaining possession to get it to the side of the goal. That's cleared. McLennan kicks it into the corner, but Ottawa will get on it and get it out and down the floor. Penalty's over. Face-off win for Ottawa. Pallotta. Cost with a shot. Ends up down in the corner, excuse me. Good work, keep it in. Heather Berzins. Blomberg flips it down the floor. I'll go right to the goaltender who will hold on. That stopped at center, brought back in by Manitoba. Mendez, her shot stopped up high, comes back to Mendez, down in along the boards. Good shift here for Manitoba Mayhem. Mendez, in along the boards. Behind the goal, hand ends. Brooke Anderson, back behind the goal. Came right out in front, comes back at the point. Marinic, Van Dens. And coming off the bench is Karpenko. Tries to jam it in. James has got it. Put the pad up against the post. Timeout. Ottawa after that good shift by Manitoba. Ottawa leads it 2-0. Manitoba threatening. Jam at the side of the goal. The ball is still loose. Then it goes into the corner. McLennan, her shot ricochets, ends up wide. Still not covered. But the net has become dislodged. Got a penalty being called. It's going to go against Ottawa again. Tanya Gwinden. Two for tripping. So Manitoba, a couple of good shifts, earned themselves a power play. See what they can do with this. They trail by two. Bird, McLennan, easy save for James. Scores! Julia Bird over on the right flank got the pass and score on the replay. Manitoba have really been coming on in the last few minutes, and then they get the power play. Here's Bird, slow to move out on her, and she goes up top shelf, 2-1. Thank you. Polchek. Dickowitz back to DeCoss. Down low, Luttrell gets it. Not out, now it'll come out. Here's a partial break. Beautour, backhand stop, rebound stopped. Finally the whistle goes. Long shot in, no traffic in front of the goaltender. Glass has that. And along the boards. Ottawa with it. Comes right to the side of the goal. That was close. Pallotta racing back, chased by Anderson. Get it in over the blue line, drop it back. Langan couldn't pull the trigger, turns. Still can't get it into shooting position, goes back to the point, back to Langan. Weak shot on goal, cleared away. Brum, down into the corner, got it to Michaud. McLennan's on her, trying to kick it free. Two more players come in. Got under a minute to go in the opening period. Scores! 38.7 seconds left to go. Ottawa get their two-goal lead back. Schroeder makes it 3-1. Fakes the pass, steps in right from the faceoff circle. 3-1. Time winding down here in the first period. Less than 10 seconds to go. Down the floor, It was touched, so no flooring. So time will likely run out in behind the Ottawa goal. And it does. Capitals jumped out to a 2-0 lead. Then Manitoba took over for a while and scored on a power play. Then that late goal restores the 2-goal lead. 3-1. Ottawa Capitals leading the Manitoba Mayhem after the opening 15 minutes. We'll be back in a couple of minutes with period number two. We've got some sort of delay as we get set to start the second period. both officials, as you can see here, over at the other side. One of the officials has left and has gone through the gate down to the right. The other official keeps looking up towards where the front lobby and such is. I have no explanation as to what's happening. Okay. It may be, as they go over now, it looks like it's with the gate at the Capitals bench. That is not closing properly. Okay, mystery solved. It's not locking, okay. It closed, but apparently it's not locking, and that's obviously a major safety issue. We can't continue until that gets fixed. As I mentioned, the other official went out through the gate down to our right. One will assume he's trying to find some stadium staff. Capitals in the bright red jerseys. No way of knowing how long this may take. Referee down below is explaining to Canada Ball Hockey President Tim McKenzie what's happening with the gate over on the other side. And somebody on the phone on the other side. That's never a good sign. You've got to call to get some help. Darius Braywell, referee in chief, came over to have a look as well. So if you're feeling a little bit hungry, folks, now would be a good time to go grab a sandwich, heat up a pot of soup. Looks like we may have a minute. Might be able to order out. Don't know what to tell you, folks. I mean, it is what it is. The game cannot resume until that problem is fixed. I'm not seeing a whole lot of activity over there. I can tell you that we are going to have another women's game after this one. We will have the Saskatoon Stingers take on the Edmonton Cherry Pickers. If we ever get this one going again. Oh, somebody's got a tool in their hand. That's progress. Or is that the broken piece from the door, which would not be progress? No, looks like a hammer. No, I don't know. Maybe not. No. Tough to tell as he was twirling it around. You know the old joke that the guy said yesterday, I went out and bought a hammer for. A hammer for? What's a hammer for? Driving nails. Really stuck for material here, as you can tell. Anyway, after the next women's game, that's going to be it for the preliminary rounds here at the Lord Beaverbrook. We move into all playoff games after that, starting tonight, 6:55. Pending that time. It'll be the men's legends. The first place team in Pool A will take on the fourth place team in Pool B, and vice versa. Their second game will be first in Pool B versus fourth in Pool A. And that will round things out for today. And then tomorrow we'll start with quarterfinals in the women's. We'll start at 9:00 tomorrow morning. Tuesday and Wednesday we started at 9:30. This morning was at 11, so 9:00 tomorrow morning. Make note of that. Two women's quarterfinals, a couple of men's A quarterfinals, men's masters semifinals, and then a couple of men's A semifinals. Saturday is all medal games. The concern I have right now is that I'm not seeing anybody different come out with anything. I don't know what's happening behind the scenes, but down at that gate, there is nothing happening yet. Put some caution tape over there and just tell people not to play in that area. Some traffic cones up there. You'd do it in phys ed class if you had a leak in the gym, right? Not quite the same here. Yeah, this is also not a good sign. They're going to toss out some ball hockey balls for the players to just continue to kind of warm up and stay loose through all this. Anybody just logging in, we've got a what appears to be a major delay. It's the gate, the players' bench for the Ottawa Capitals is not closing properly. It closes, but won't stay closed. It won't lock. But we've got somebody with a hand drill. Well, now we're making progress. Players have been told to just go out and stay loose through all of this. The referee has blown his whistle, and it looks like whatever the guy with the drill did, whatever that was, it fixed it. So we are all very appreciative of Drill Guy. He gets player of the game. All this happened during the first intermission, so we're just getting set to start the second period. Ottawa leading 3-1. And we are underway, thankfully, here in the second period. And Ease chips it out, it'll go down the floor. And that will be a flooring call to start this second period. Ottawa coming in off the board, shot it just wide. Kept in by Smith. Comes through the front of the goal and cleared away by Manitoba. The wave off the flooring, players get there. Ottawa off the boards. Mazzarello pinned against the boards by Bird. Anderson working along the board, cycles it back down low, picked up back there by Cirelli. Cirelli threw it right through the crease, went by everybody and picked up by Ottawa, and they'll bring it out. Ball goes out of play. Faceoff will be just outside the Ottawa blue line. Just outside the Manitoba blue line. Quick pass, breaking on the right side. Luttrell forced to the boards. Great pass, Beautour! Time to pick her spot. I think it went off the defenseman who slid in front. There's Katie Matula. Beautour in the backhand scores. In front, the ball just comes loose. Beautour gets to it, backhands it up high. Not much chance there for the goaltender. Coming off of that scramble right in front of her. And it is 4-1. And they come again. Beautour has already got two. She steals it. Adrienne Beautour into the slot. Kyra Brum will try and maybe make the extra pass. Ends up down in the corner. Brum's going to hold it in. Getting a stick in the way of that was Heather Beersens. Shot right on goal. The rebound lies there. Glass able to keep it out on the second try. Ottawa all over Manitoba right now. It's going to go right to the goaltender, and James is going to hold it. Thought about moving it, but then Juliana Duma was right there on her doorstep. It's one of those ones, if you're going to move it, you've got to make up your mind as the ball is coming in that you're going to move it. Back at the point, slap shot kicked away by James. Slashing penalty. And it's going to go against Manitoba. 4 minutes. Kiara Procek gone to the penalty box. So a 4 minute power play for the Capitals, already leading it 4-1. Misfired on the shot and cleared out. He'll get it in. Mazzarello takes it deep, back at the point. Latriel, the other side. It'll be kept in. Comes through the near boards. Ottawa's on it. Back at the point. They'll swing it the other way. Shot right on goal. Glass makes the save. No rebound this time. This side, at the outside of the net, Jessica Schroeder. Schroeder's got it again. Back up to Pallotta, to Schroeder. Beautour knocked that down nicely. Good hand-eye coordination. Schroeder shoots. Save made by Glass. Beautour directing traffic. Up to Pallotta, and that's picked off. Sent down the floor, Angie Sorelli. Takes Pallotta to the boards. Sorelli's gonna try and kill some time, doing good work. Finally, it comes loose. They get it in. Schroeder. Pallotta shot goes wide, comes off the end boards. They're going to just push it into their goaltender so Glass can hold it and get a face-off. Minute 27 left to go in that four-minute slashing penalty to Manitoba. That's held. Blockered away by Glass. Back at the point, kept in. No, it's not. The shorthanded opportunity. Brownridge. No penalty, and I tell you, Manitoba, very upset. Hendricks. I'm sorry, that's 13, not 12. That's Mazzarello. Taken and sent down the floor. Good penalty kill here. By Manitoba, just 40 seconds left to go in the power play. And it's stolen, shorthanded opportunity. Touched up by Ottawa, it's gonna be a penalty for holding. Great work by Chelsea Van Dens. She went in forechecking, shorthanded, stole the ball, stepped out in front and drew a penalty against Ottawa. 4-on-4 for 32 seconds, and then it'll be a power play for Manitoba. Just under a minute and a half. To the far boards, getting in there, Katie Matula. Brooke Anderson, back to Matula. Steps around the Ottawa player, then doesn't get it in front of the goal. It's taken away by Botor. Doesn't bother to bring it in, waits. And now it is a power play for Manitoba. Stumped in. That's going to go all the way back. The pass came from their own side of the center red line. 1 minute, 1 second to go in the power play. Beersons, Manitoba still on the power play, 35 seconds left to go. That shot drifts right on goal, the rebound is there, James makes two saves. Good, hard, low shot by Jesse Dickowitz. That's tipped just wide by Van Dens. Sorelli, her shot missed short side. That'll go up the glass and out of play, and the faceoff will come outside the blue line. 12 seconds to go in the power play. Into the corner, behind the goal. The power play is over. We'll take that off the board. Stewart. Picked off out at the blue line and shot it on goal, and Glass will not give up a rebound. Good pinch by Doucette to keep it in for Ottawa. Now it'll come out. It's 2-on-1. Bragg shoots. Save was made by James. Doucette back to Brum. Started off like a 2-on-1, but didn't end up that way, as the other Manitoba player had to wait at the blue line for the ball to be brought in, and by that time some of the Ottawa players had gotten back. Right through the crease, nobody touched it. Picked up on the other side. Cycle back in behind the goal. McLennan to the near boards. That will come out. Schroeder. Pallotta. Katie Matula. Brought back in. Blomberg. Cleared away from the front of the goal, but kept onside by Ottawa. Off the stick. Goes through the boards. Matula. Trying to get it out. And poked down by McLennan. Stewart. Stewart had it taken away. Brum just rolls it on in. Heather Berzins. .341 to go. Faceoff's going to come all the way back down into the Manitoba end. Throw it across. Oh, scores! Beautiful goal. Jesse Dickowitz, the recipient of that great pass from Angie Sorelli. Manitoba back in it. Gets past the Ottawa defender right there. Here's Sorelli. You see Dickowitz on the other side. Perfect pass up over the pads of the goaltender. 4-2. Right back in it. The Manitoba Mayhem. Still in the second period, just down 2 now. Desmier along the boards. Working against Mirinyuk. Mendez hits it as far as center, then it comes out. Mazzarello leaves it. Botor. Pallotta got it in. Desmier shot, hit the outside of the goal. Botor looking for it. Stewart trying to get around the outside. She gets it in. Now it'll go into the corner. She and Pallotta go in there. Pallotta goes down hard. And that's going to be cross-checking against Manitoba. Again, another four-minute penalty. Kate Stewart. Timeout. Ottawa, they set up for this important power play here late in the second period. 2:23 to go in the period. 4 minutes for cross-checking to Manitoba. Faceoff controlled by Ottawa. Back at the point, Pallotta. Langan. Pallotta, Schroeder. Shoots. That didn't miss by a whole lot. So it went a little bit high. Langan. Pallotta. Schroeder. Pass was on her backhand. For Langan, she can one-time that one. Goaltender got a piece of it. Just enough to deflect it wide. Back to Pallotta, Langan, Schroeder. Into the middle. It's loose backhand, put wide. Langan, Pallotta back to Langan. In the slot, shot, Glass has got that. Holds on. Glass with the save. They've got Luttrell up top. Desmier went off a stick and out of play. Desmier. Back at the point. Luttrell. Desmier. Desmere with a shot. That was blocked by Urinyuk, and then it's cleared down the floor. Just 30 seconds to go in the period. Getting there first will be Brownridge. Ottawa were changing up their power play unit. Allow Brownridge to get there first. That's going to kill some time. And there's not a lot of time left in the period, 12 seconds. That's going to do it. Minute 37 will be left in the power play for Ottawa. When we come back to start the third period, Ottawa leads this game by a score of 4-2. We'll be back with the third period in a couple of minutes. Ottawa still on the power play to start this third period, minute 30 to go in that penalty to Manitoba. Langan took the pass on the backhand, shot it. That one off of Matula, up and out of play, or Urinyuk rather, number 20. Shot just drifts in lazily to the goaltender glass. No trouble with that. changing up their power play. 1:03 left to go. A little late getting their two defense out there. Now we're set to go. The Pallotta and Brum. There's Pallotta. Over to Brum. That's tipped over the top and into the corner. It'll come back to Pallotta. Not sure what that was intended to do, but it was picked off by Manitoba and sent down the floor. 30 seconds left to go in the power play. They get it in. Desmier right in front, losing it on the handles. Beautour, Brum following up on it. Goes in behind the goal. 15 seconds to go in the power play. They can't get it out. Brum. Back to Blomberg. Desmier shot. That was stopped by Glass. Penalty's over. Ottawa maintained possession. Desmier. Desmier again shot it just wide. That didn't miss by much. Goaltenders lost their stick. Gets it back. Got an Ottawa player shaking up down behind the play. Getting back to her feet, Mazzarello. Ottawa effectively shorthanded in their own end as Mazzarello has the long run to get back to her bench. Had she stayed down, I think the referee would have blown the whistle, but she started to get up and then made her way, although rather gingerly, back to the bench. And give her credit for that. Nice touch with a high stick, and that's going to go back all the way into the Ottawa end, and Ottawa trying to get a change in. They're not going to allow it. Again, that's the new rule that came in just a few years ago. If there's a high sticking infraction where the ball is touched with a high stick and someone on that team first to touch it, whistle is blown, faceoff comes back in the offending team zone and they cannot change. Prior to that rule, it used to be a penalty to even play the ball with a high stick, for the purpose of player safety. Canada Ball Hockey changed the rule a few years ago to bring it in line with the ISBHF, International Street and Ball Hockey Federation's rule, and more like the closer to traditional hockey high-sticking rule. Ball goes to the boards. Ottawa lug it out to Hendricks. Hendricks cutting into the middle. Hendricks with a shot that was stopped. Quickly in through the middle. Unable to move on it was Manitoba. That was close. They almost got away. Hit the outside of the net. Manitoba pressing here, down by just two. Tipped away, racing after it. Lavoie getting back first. Beersons Pallotta back to get it. To Brum. She'll bank it off the boards. Michaud on it first. Michaud with a shot. Glass made the save, and Glass covers the rebound. Michaud. Back to Pallotta. Back to Michaud. Scores! Beautour. Or actually Langan, 97. Back to a three-goal lead. Pallotta and Michaud did good work here over on those boards. And then it comes three. Langan. Again, Glass didn't really see that. Winden got it towards the goal and ended up in behind. Played back by Smith. Smith in the corner. Up along the glass. Ball comes free along the boards. Knocked down by Luttrell. She'll continue on down into the corner. Dumped in. Dickowitz goes in there with Doucette. Dickowitz goes down. And the referee will blow the whistle. Knocked down with a high stick. First touch by Ottawa. Play continues. Desmier. That shot in wide. Picked up on the far boards by Beautour. And that will go out of play. Desmier shoots, stopped by Glass. Glass covers it at the side of the goal. Manitoba bring it out. Juliana Dumas stopped. Coming back, Lavoie. Slapped off the boards by McLennan. Julia Bird. Up a little bit further. On it is Duma. In to help out Stewart. Matula. Brom quickly ahead. Good pass. Michaud. Chases it down in the corner. Gets it back to Schroeder. Back at the point. Pallotta. It's knocked down. Michaud. All the way back to Pallotta. Michaud in front off the stick of the defender and behind the goal. Schroeder. Langen. Back to Pallotta. Scores. With Langen behind the goal. Here's Pallotta coming in off the right point. Nobody found her. It's a couple of cracks at it. Gets it by Glass, and it is now 6-2. So it would appear Ottawa will go to 4-0 to remain undefeated throughout the preliminary games, not just undefeated, but won all their games. They will join Newfoundland and Labrador United with that. They are also 4-0 after winning their game earlier today. Manitoba will fall to 1-3. .5:39 to go, second or third period. Up next, another women's ace, Saskatoon Stingers, Edmonton Cherry Pickers. That game will be a little late, scheduled to start at 5 minutes from now. Penalty to Ottawa, Jenna Hendricks. And the reason we're late is that fairly lengthy delay we had earlier, where they had trouble with the gate over at the Ottawa bench between the first and second periods. Confusion there. They get away with it. There's Manitoba. Down in the corner, Anderson. Try and work the give and go. It's broken up by Blomberg. Bragg back. Kicked away by James. And James will cover it. We're down to 4:40 to go. Still on the power play, Manitoba. Forty-two seconds left to go in their advantage. Stewart back to McLennan, and it's cleared into the Ottawa bench. Penalty is now over. Krochik gets it up along the boards. Battle along the boards. It'll be kept in. Pearson's. Dickowitz's shot over the top of the goal. Under three to play. Brum. Kept in by Manitoba. That's still onside. Krochik on goal, and James forced to cover it. Tour dumped it in for Ottawa. It'll come back out. Pallotta goes back to get it. Brought in Van Dens. Sorelli. Behind the goal. It comes in front, back at the point. Stepping into that was Mendez. It was blocked. That goes into the corner. Sorelli on it first. She's pushed to the boards by Doucette. Pallotta has it. Desmier. Teammate was heading off. Smith gets it over the blue line. Good pass. Just over, running it a little bit. It was Gwinden. Now she's got it again. Turning to the outside. Right into the goalkeeper, and Glass will hold on. A minute 19 to go. Behind the Manitoba goal into the final minute of this game. Ottawa content to keep the ball down low, let the clock run. While in the referee wants them to move it, but that's not going to happen. Balls in to James. She'll hold that. Kept in by Berzins. Berzins stepping in. Berzins with his shot. Again, covered up by James. Just 6 seconds left to go. Take it back behind the goal. That will do it. 6-2 final. Ottawa Capitals go to 4-0. Manitoba fall to 1-3. One more preliminary game to go here at the Lord Beaverbrook Rink. That in the women's between the Saskatoon Stingers and the Edmonton Cherry Pickers. And we will have that one for you as soon as we get the player of the game presentations and the teams get their 5-minute warm-up. We will be ready to go with our final preliminary game. Then we will have two quarterfinals in the Legends division to finish off our day. The victorious Ottawa Capitals, they're looking good. Setting up for a clash between Ottawa and Newfoundland and Labrador. Lots to happen before then. We've got quarterfinals and semifinals to get through. And upsets do happen on a regular basis. Team further ahead in the preliminaries don't always win their playoff games. I'm telling you something you already know. All right, let's get the player of the game. Again, it'll be Elio Pascuzzo on the mic. I find it's a little tough to pick up the PA announcing in this lovely old rink. It's such an interesting rink. I've been in so many over the years, and this one is quickly becoming one of my favorites. The game for Ottawa, number 17, Marie-Philippe Lavoie. All right, time for us to grab a little break. Next game will get underway as quickly as they can. It was scheduled for 5:25, which is 1 minute. Actually, it was scheduled for 5:20, 6 minutes ago. So let's get that one going as quickly as possible. We had a delay in that previous game. I had a malfunction at the bench. I had to get a door fixed between the first and second period, and that put us a little bit behind, but not by a whole lot. We do invite you to come back and take in that game between the and the Edmonton Cherry Pickers coming up next. You're watching the 2023 Men's and Women's A, the Masters and Legends, Canadian Ball Hockey Championships from St. John, New Brunswick.